What makes a face a face? The very first painting that I worked on, it was a landscape taken from a photo, which is frequently how artists, many artists, learn to paint. The woman who was teaching, her name was Jean Wisdom, one of the first things she said to me was that I had a gift that I didn't know that I had. I never had anyone say that to me in my life before, and I was willing to believe her. She was influential in a way that she really never knew, in that the few short months that I painted with her, the times that I would spend time talking about art and music and life with her, put me in a trajectory in my life that I never could have imagined. From that first painting, it really became an evolution. My art and how I got to the point that I'm at today. This whole experience with process painting happened about 10 years ago. I had a friend who was an artist, and he had a friend who was teaching this class that she called process painting. The idea was, we used inexpensive paper, we taped it to the wall, and we used tempera paint. So, and the way she explained it, she said, you just pick up a color and you start painting. You know, when you're not thinking about what it looks like in the end, it frees you up, because what it ultimately does is it frees you from your critical mind. It frees you from your judging mind. And what I noticed, even in the class that I took on process painting, is that the compositions that I created felt like they were more about energy than they were about a familiar object or a familiar theme. And so I continued that exploration with energy, and what began to emerge were these faces. You know, after an hour of this, I'd step back and I'd see these faces. And so I began to explore, just through process painting, every morning, painting a face, but not a face of anyone that I knew, but just, you know, going to the canvas with raw color, whatever the color was of the day, and paint. But do it quickly and do it effortlessly and without any judgment of what it was going to look like in the end. I intentionally bring this handwritten technique to my canvases, and I do that because it's really, not only graphically do I think it's an interesting way to add texture and depth to my work, but people find some hidden message here. I think part of my exploration with abstraction was to see if I could identify what makes a face. Is it an eye? If the eye is missing in an abstract face, do we still see it as a face? So one of the things I've discovered for myself is that some of the faces that seem to be most abstract, there's certainly a suggestion of a nose or a suggestion of lips, but mostly they're abstract forms, abstract shapes that have pattern or texture in them. And yet it's this eye, it's the realism of the eye, is somehow the window into the story. There was something liberating about just painting without a judging mind, without a critical mind. And the thing that I've learned over the years is that this is what most artists struggle with the most, is our own attachment to what we think our art should look like. What came out of that was a whole new body of work, a whole new way of thinking about painting, a whole new way of approaching painting that I'd never experienced before.